Welcome back, food lovers. In this video, we will be downloading and installing the Foodie Pro theme. If you want to know why we picked this theme, go back and watch episode 2 of this series. Then come back here and let's get cooking. First, log into your Feast account and navigate to the download section under your account details. We want to download the Genesis framework and the Foodie Pro Classic theme. Next, we'll move over to your WordPress dashboard. Go to the Appearance section and click on Themes. To add a new one, click on Add New at the top of the page and then select Upload Theme. Choose the Genesis zip file you downloaded earlier. Click Install Now to begin the installation process. Now this is important. Do not click on Activate or Live Preview. Instead, press on the Go to Themes page button. Then go through the steps again to upload the foodiepro.zip file. And now we want to click on the Activate button. Well done, you've just installed the Foodie Pro theme. But starting from a blank canvas can be intimidating. To get a head start, we want to import some demo content. To do this, go to Tools on the left sidebar and select Import. Choose WordPress from the list of import options and run the importer. You will be prompted to upload an XML file. Navigate to your download folder, select the Foodie Pro zip file, and double-click on it to unzip it. Within the folder, search for another folder called Sample Data. This foodiepro.xml file is what we need to upload in order to see all the sample content. Once the file is uploaded, you will see options to assign a user. Most of you will have one existing user, which could be named after your name, or like in our case here, just be a long string of numbers and letters. Select the user and then check the Import Attachments checkbox, telling WordPress that we want to include all of the images and other file attachments. Congratulations! If you go to Posts or Pages in your WordPress dashboard, you should see all sample posts and pages right there. Now the last thing we need to import are the widgets. We'll explain in detail what those widgets are and what they do later in this video. Go to the Plugins section and click on Add New. In the search bar, type Widget Importer and Exporter to find the plugin. Click on Install Now and then Activate to enable the plugin. After activation, navigate once again to Tools, but this time select the Widget Importer and Exporter. Click on Choose File and go back to the Sample Data folder. Select the foodieprowidgets.wie file. You should now see a list of widgets that have been successfully imported. You will also see some red lines saying, "Site does not support widget." No need to worry about that. You can install them later on, but for starting right now, we don't need them. Now begins the fun part. Let's go to Appearance, Widgets, and click on the Manage with Live Preview button. The Foodie Pro theme has a main sidebar area here on the right side, and a big homepage area that is divided up in multiple parts: top, middle, and bottom. Above this is the area called the header, and right at the bottom of the page is the footer. By default, the homepage displays your featured or most recent posts. Let's take a closer look at the sidebar. If we hover or click on a widget, we can see a blue box pop up around it. This way, we can always know what we are looking at. When clicking on Add a Widget, you can see a list with all the available widgets. Let's choose the Calendar widget just as an example, and let's drag and drop it below the Recent Post widget. Let's add another widget, but this time to the homepage top area. Adding some post categories would be nice. But now, what if you feel like this would look better on the sidebar? You can press Reorder and then press on this icon to move it to another widget area. It will arrive right at the bottom. So go and drag it up a bit. Nice. Make sure to play around with these widgets. It can be a bit overwhelming at the start, so don't stress. Just try adding and moving some widgets so that you know how your theme works. If we exit the widgets menu, we see the other site settings. Here we can set a header image and upload our logo. For some inspiration, you can take a look at some of the other blogs created with the Foodie Pro theme. But remember, creating good posts is what is most important when starting out. And that's exactly what we'll be covering in the next episode. Make sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out. Thanks for watching, and happy blogging!